So these are heated concrete slabs, and we have conductive agents on top of the layer, and then we have stainless steel electrodes. When we turn the system on, then we start generating heat on top of the slabs, and it helps us to melt ice and snow so that we can keep these systems open and accessible during winter weather events. To make this an economic construction, we have two layers of concrete. Bottom layer is regular concrete, only the top layer is the electrically conductive concrete. We were able to work with a local, concrete plant here and local contractors. They were actually able to construct this system very successfully without any prior training. This shows that actually it can be implemented in any place. The system is working really well. And when we turn all the slabs on, we can actually see the heating taking place right away. When we look at the thermal imaging system, you can see the red areas, the heated concrete versus the blue areas, you know, the cold control slabs. We are successfully able to melt it away, and you can see steam coming out of the other slabs. There are actually a very good number of applications for heated slabs, heated pavement systems. And sidewalks where we have a lot of human traffic, bridge decks, and if we're talking about airports, the gate areas. The best way to run this system is that we turn it on at least an hour in advance of any, the snow and ice event, so that there will be no accumulation of the snow and ice particles. One of the biggest advantages of this technology is actually environmental benefits in addition to the safety. We are actually eliminating the use of harmful de-icing chemicals and provide a safe platform for the traveling, the public. That's the ultimate goal for us.